Hi YouTube, this is a free extract from my larger Illustrator Advanced course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Also, there's a link in the description for the exercise files. Those are free to download, so go and download those. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, it is advanced pen tool tips and tricks time in Illustrator. Now, if you are a bit afraid of the pen tool still, you might want to check out the Essentials course. Okay, it goes through the pen tool in a lot more kind of, I guess, a bit more of a basic understanding. This one here is going to jump straight into the you're an okay user of pen tool and you want to take it to the next level. So get a notepad out. There's a few little shortcuts and key combinations to make this work and go fast. But yeah, let's get in there, redraw this little doll thing and make it look like this. All right, let's get started. Okay, so advanced pen tool time. Let's bring in an image, so file place. And let's bring in from your exercise files one called pen tool. Where are you, pen tool? There you are there. Make sure it's a template, click place, so it's on its own layer and locked. Next thing is under properties, let's grab our pen tool from our toolbar. Okay, and make sure we've got a fill of none. Okay, and we'll have a stroke of black, that's fine. One of the first things you need to do when using the pen tool is turn off the smart guide. So Command U turns it off, otherwise it starts trying to snap to things and you lose your mojo. Now, first trick is for better curves, right? Say I want to do this curvy bit down the bottom here. You might be at a habit or the way you were taught by clicking once for a corner, clicking and dragging for a curve, and then a corner here. Now, that is fine, but often you can get nicer curves by using handles out of these corner points. So I'm going to start by clicking and dragging out, and I'm dragging out a curve. I'm dragging towards the line I want to go, and roughly about there, and then watch this. I'm going to drag out. Okay, and I get the same line with less anchor points. And you'll find that if you have just two anchor points using handles, it'll just give you a nice smoother shape than you would get from doing, you know, two corners with a curve in the middle. And the trouble runs into if you want to change direction here, because it's a corner, right? We knew it was a corner when we drew it. So that brings me on to my next shortcut. If you've got a curve where you want it to be a corner, you can just hold down the Alt key on a Mac or the Option key on a PC. Okay, and you can see I've broken it there. Okay, and I'm going to go up to here and I want it to be a curve still, so I'm going to click and drag out. Okay, I can break it again later on, remember, by holding the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac and breaking it as I'm drawing, rather than kind of drawing it out and then having to go back to the Convert Anchor Point tool or the white arrow. Okay, it's just a nice handy extra trick. So that's one way of doing it. Let's show you even better way, and the way I normally draw is with the pen tool. Okay, so I'm going to click and drag out here to get this first curve, click and drag out, and instead of doing what we did before is draw it and then kind of come back to it and break it using the Option key or the Alt key on a PC, is you can actually do it here. Before you start, you know, when you get it kind of roughly where you want it to, just hold down the Alt key on a PC and an Option key on a Mac, that same key, okay, before you let go, and it actually snaps it while you're going. Okay, so I'll often do this and drag out. Let's say I want to keep these curves. I'm doing a real rough job to speed through, but I get to here and I drag it out, and then I hold Alt and just bring it up this way because I know that's going to give me roughly where I want to go. Okay, and we're going to get to this point. Okay, so Alt breaks it, but you get to this point, and I know I need it to be really long to get that existing curve, right? But I know that this top point up here, you can see like, oh man, it's kind of gone too far, and you end up, you'll have your methods to fix that up. But what you can do is, watch this, while I'm dragging that one out, if you hold down the Command key on a Mac or the Control key on a PC, you can, it still keeps it like locked, but it brings this handle in so that the extent is not as far. Okay, so while you're dragging, you can kind of shorten one of them by holding the Command key. I know these are all a little bit tough to remember, but you've got your notepad next to you and you're going to just spend, whenever you're doing your next drawing, just kind of like, okay. You might only use two or three of them, but I find I use all of them and it just makes my pen tool experience a lot better. Another one we're going to do is, say like I get along here and I start drawing and it's just not quite on the line, right? What I can do before I let go is just hold down the spacebar key. And then when I move my mouse, it's moving the anchor point. Okay, so I can continue on, get it perfect. All right, so that's going to be it for Super Shortcuts. What I'd like you to do for your project is to kind of finish off this drawing. You can use the pen tool or the curvature tool, okay, which we learned in the previous video. It's up to you. Just get a rough drawing. Don't worry if it's not perfect. I'd like you to do it because we're going to use it as an example later on to kind of color it in, show you how to kind of color in a hand-drawn drawing. One of the things that you might run into is like, how do you want to complete this? Now, you're going to get to like this point here and go, okay, do I go down here or up this way? Okay, so let's just turn it into a pile of pieces. What I mean by that is that I'm going to grab my black arrow, okay, and just click off in the background, and I'm going to draw it as a separate line. We will join them all up later on using some cool tool called the Shape Builder tool. So I'm just going to click and drag down here, and do I want it to join? Yeah, probably do. But you can see here, I'm not worried that it doesn't go around and completely joins. We're going to go through and connect these up a different way. So pen tool, let's say this line here, and there's this kind of hand. Okay, all I'm going to do is click once and just click once there. Okay, and that's going to be enough for what I need. I'm going to use the pen tool now. Okay, and I'm going to draw a curve. I'm going to draw a curve. 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 What I might do is just kind of overlap this a little bit, because do I want to get them all perfect aligned there? It becomes too hard to draw that way. Okay, so we're going to overlap that, and what I'll do is I'll draw that foot over the top, and we'll trim it up using the Shape Builder tool. So that's the kind of technique that I want you to use. Just make sure everything doesn't have to overlap completely like this. It can be close like that, and we'll show you later on that there's a magic way of kind of joining those up. I like to go through, draw all the lines that you can see here. Don't stress too much about it, but this might be a really good time to practice your super amazing, fantastic new advanced pen tool tricks. All right, I'm back. I was just kind of drawing this and I thought, actually, there's probably more I can add to this video, because one of the big problems is, let's say we're using any of the tools. Okay, I'm using the pen tool. Is if I kind of say I want to click over here, it's going to really want to join up to this tool. Okay, or join up to the end of these lines. You're like, oh, stop connecting up. Okay, the easiest way is, say the curvature tool is the worst for it, right? If I start down here and I put a one there, and I want to go to this, it really wants to kind of do stuff with this. You're like, well, what happened? We were just doing this line. Okay, the easiest way is just to go zoom in real quick. Okay, so if I click there, joined up. Click there. I've really exaggerated these lines. You can see they all overlap. We'll tidy that up in a future tutorial. But click once, and where it gets in here, where it really wants to join, just zoom in. Okay, I'm using Command Plus. You might use Control Plus, and just click in here. It gives you, I guess, a bigger room to kind of, you know, so it's not kind of trying to guess these lines. So I often do that, zooming in just to kind of make sure it doesn't join up with other lines. Another thing that I kind of realize while I'm working is that to deselect, you can go to the black arrow or hit the V key. The shortcut I use the most is holding the Command key down. You can see you get the black arrow, and just click off in the background. So while I'm drawing, so let's say we want to draw this line. So click once, I'm using the curvature tool, click once. So I've got just a nice curve, but it keeps on joining. So I'll hold Command and just click off in the background so I can start again. And again, it's going to really want to join that line. So if I zoom right in, you're holding spacebar to click and hold and drag this around. I'm just going to start, you know, kind of exaggerate this. And I'm going to try and avoid this line here. Click once, click once. Go curvature tool, built for making weird hair flowers. Okay, click off in the background. All right, one last thing before I go is when you get to the end of your drawing, because we're gonna kind of color this in later on, you're kind of left with a ugly looking drawing, okay? All the things overlap and it's not very nice. A nice little easy trick is I'm selecting it all with my black arrow, holding down the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac. Okay, and just making a duplicate. And with it selected, just go over to Stroke and pick something down here where it says Profile. Let's pick something nicer, like this first one here, the Width Profile. Just gives it a nice kind of hand-drawn-y look. I've bumped mine up to 3 points. Looks a bit better. Like I said, Shape Builder tool, we're going to make this and fill it in and do some cool colors. All right, that's it for advanced pen tool stuff. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Hey there, I hope you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. It really helps out what I do. I've got lots of other stuff here on YouTube, so consider subscribing. Also, I wanna see what you made. Okay, so you're obviously doing something. Don't be shy, I'd love to see what it is. If you put it up on Instagram, I'd love to, for you to mention me. I'm Bring Your Own Laptop on Instagram, and on Twitter, I'm Dan Loves Adobe. Also, if you like my teaching style and you know you want more advanced Illustrator stuff, there's the full course. Okay, it's on bringyourownlaptop.com. There'll be a link in the description. Also on Bring Your Own Laptop is there's a resources tab and there's a free cheat sheet in there. Free, totally downloadable. It has all the kind of, we did the keyboard shortcuts and stuff for Illustrator. It's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer. It's awesome. All right, continue on. Bye now.